Proverbs chapter 27, verse 18. The Bible declares, "Whoso keepeth the fig tree shall eat the fruit thereof. So he that waiteth on his master shall be honored." Ladies and gentlemen, the Spirit of the Lord told me to speak to you about waiting on God. You know what time it is. Perspicacity Movers, let's get it.
Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? And they can't defeat me, that's the whole thing. Cause heaven's above me and God reigns. These truths I have to proclaim, make plain. So you could understand what it is I lay claim to. What I've gone through, to remind those who don't know how to find what's true, making sure we give honor to where I'm.
What is going on, ladies and gentlemen? This is Apostle Makhario coming to you all again. And the Spirit of the Lord spoke to me the other day in my daily studies, and this verse really stood out to me. And the Lord told me to teach you all about this on waiting on the Lord. In verse, and I'm sure I've taught on this before, but this is a different teaching or revelation that the Lord wanted me to give you in regards to waiting on the Lord. Now, Proverbs 27:18, it says, "Whoso keepeth the fig tree shall eat the fruit thereof, so he that waiteth on his master shall be honored." These two things work together, right? Many times when people are waiting on God or waiting on the Lord, they are not waiting in faith. Or they're waiting on God, but they're not doing anything toward that thing they want to accomplish or what they want to reach. You can have a dream of becoming a multimillionaire, but if you're not doing anything toward becoming a multimillionaire and you're just expecting it to fall out of the sky, you're going to miss God. Because you can't wait on the Lord without actually putting in work. That's why the Bible declares in James chapter 2, verse 17, "Even so faith, if it hath not works, is dead, being alone." You could have faith. You say, "I'm waiting on God," and you're waiting in faith. But if you're waiting in faith, you're actually doing something to get toward that goal. When people say they want to be a multimillionaire, especially Christians, but they don't want to tithe 10%, which is a principle that God set in place many, many years ago, way before us. 10%. I remember teaching someone what the scripture says in regards to tithe and offering, and they were like, "We have to give 10%. I say, "Yes." And they were like, "That's a lot." And I'm sitting there and I told that person, I say, "Your heart isn't right concerning God, because that means you're still idolizing the money. If 10% of what you make is a lot to you and God gives you the other 90%, then your heart is not right and God can't bless you in that manner, because you still haven't realized that he gives you all those things, including that 10%. So to give him 10% back should not be an issue. So you say, "I want to be a multimillionaire," but you won't give God 10%. I'll tell you what I do personally, and God has always blessed my life. As soon as I get paid, I pay God first. I pay his 10% and whatever else I give first. As soon as it hits my account or my money hits my bank, that's what I do first. I give God the first fruit of everything that I receive. So 10% goes to God first, plus whatever offering to wherever he tells me to give that to. You cannot expect God to bless you when your heart is not right concerning that situation. So if money is idolatry to you, and that 10%, you feel like you could do something better with it instead of giving it to the place where God is set to help reach other people, then God can't bless you to be a multimillionaire. Or for those of you that are doing it and you say, "Well, I believe in God, I'm living for God," or whatever, but then you're going out there and you're gambling. No, you're not, because that's not the way that God is saying wait on him. That's why it says, "Whoso keepeth the fig tree shall eat the fruit thereof, so he that waiteth on his master shall be honored." You want to till that ground, do what you have to do regarding what God is giving you. And once you do what you have to do regarding what God is giving you, then it says you wait on the Lord. But if you're waiting on the Lord without actually putting in the work, you're not waiting on the Lord. When people say, "Well, I want to get to a better or a deeper spiritual place in God," but they don't put in the work of studying the Word of God or fasting or praying, they're not actually waiting on the Lord. They're waiting on the Lord expecting God to do it like a genie, just because they say, "God, I want it." And God is like, "That's not how I work." That's why the Spirit of the Lord wanted me to teach you this. And that's why the Bible also says in James 2:17, "Even so faith, if it hath not works, is dead being alone. You say, I'm waiting on God, and you say you're doing that in faith, but you're not putting any works behind the faith. That's why it's dead. That's why you're not reaching that level that you want to reach in God, whether it be that money situation that I explained to you, or whether it be that which I just mentioned concerning spiritual things in God. You have to wait on the Lord, but you wait while you work, or you're working while you wait, because once God sees that you're actually putting effort in that direction for Him to be able to bless you, He'll do it, but it takes time. And many people are not patient with waiting on God. I'll give you an example, and I'm going to give you a couple other scriptures here as well. But one example is my mother and I, when we were living in Florida, and my mom's side of the family, they're from the Bahamas. Some of you may know it as well if you have Spanish family or different cultures of family that actually practice magic. But what they would do is, in the church world, and my grandfather, which was a bishop, told my mother these things, and my grandmother told my mother these things, that in the church world, what people would do in the Bahamas is they would pray to God. And you'll find this in Africa too. And when they pray to God, if God wasn't moving fast enough for them, they go to a witch doctor and they try to get it done. So witchcraft is manipulation, as you all know, and I teach you all that all the time. So instead of them actually waiting on the Lord and putting effort toward that thing so God could bless them, they said to themselves, well, God, you're not moving fast enough. So because you're not doing that, I'm going to go to the witch doctor and get it done a little quicker. But see, now you're operating in witchcraft, so you're operating outside of God instead of operating in faith. All you need to do is study the Word of God, know His Word, study, fast, and pray, and work toward the goal that you want to reach. And in doing that, you have to do it patiently. I'm going to give you something that I gave you all before, but one of the prophets texted me the other day, and I actually text this verse back to them. And that is Hebrews chapter 10. Verse 36, and I've given you all this scripture before, but it says, well, one, let's go to 35. It says, cast not away therefore your confidence, which have great recompense of reward, right? I told you all I love that scripture. I wrote it on my heart many years ago. It says in verse 36, for ye have need of patience, that after ye have done the will of God, you might receive the promise. If you say, I'm waiting on God, and you're waiting, but you feel like He's not moving fast enough, and you go and try to get it done yourself through a witch doctor or through magic, white or black magic, Santeria, Wicca, whatever it is, you're not waiting on God the way you're supposed to be. You need to repent, because now you're operating in witchcraft, and God hates that. The Old Testament said, God said, I suffer not a witch to live. God did not suffer witches to live. That's not something He wanted. So for you to go to a psychic, or go to someone that does magic, or someone that talks to quote-unquote the dead, which are actually demons, you are not waiting on God. You have need of patience, that after you have done the will of God, you might receive the promise. God is not going to just do it just because you ask. He has to see that your faith with works, that you're waiting on God the right way, and that you're working toward it. And in due season, when your heart is right, then God shall bless you with that which you need, or that which you desire. Let's go to, also, I love you, Jesus, Matthew chapter 7. The other thing about waiting on the Lord, or actually, let's go to Isaiah 40:31. It says, but they that wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Ladies and gentlemen, that is the thing. You are waiting on the Lord, and when you do it, and you do it the right way, He said, you shall renew your strength, which is the first thing. He said, you shall mount up with wings as eagles, which means you're going to soar if you wait on God properly. And then He says, you shall run and not be weary, so you won't get tired of running. You know how we do in the natural? We run until we get tired, or we sprint. And then once we get tired, we kind of slow down our pace. And then once we get too tired, we just start walking. He said, you'll run and not be weary. You shall walk and not faint. So if you wait on God the right way, God can bless you. Wait on God the right way. And let me give you one last verse. And this is what the Lord was giving me. And God spoke to me about this earlier in the week. I'm just now giving it to you all. This is the week following, because you're going to see this on Monday, most likely. But this is important for you to know. Waiting on God means that you wait, but you work toward the goal you're trying to accomplish. You don't just expect God to drop it out of the sky. Genie stuff, that magic stuff, is not of God. That's not how God works. And you have to have the right heart for God to be able to bless you. You have to be mature in Christ in order for God to do it for you. You can't just expect God to give it to you, and then once you get it, you're right back in the situation you were before because you didn't know what to do with it. Don't let your gift take you where your character can't keep you. I told you all about that before. We say that in the church world quite a bit. You can have a gift, and it'll take you somewhere, but your character won't sustain you there. Do not let your gift take you where your character can't keep you. Matthew chapter 7, and this is what Jesus said, and nobody's words are greater than Jesus, so we're going to end it with what Jesus said, and I'll take you back to Proverbs 27. But it says, "Ask, and it shall be given you. Seek, and ye shall find. Knock, and it shall be opened unto you. For everyone that asketh, receiveth. And he that seeketh, findeth. And to him that knocketh, it shall be opened." So he said, you could ask, you're asking in faith. And then Jesus clarified it for him. He said, for everyone that ask, receive. And then he says, seek. So you, that means you're not just sitting there and expecting it to fall. He said, ask me, and then do what you have to do to receive it. Ask me, and then look for the opportunity for it to come to pass. That's why Jesus said in verse 7, for everyone that asketh, receiveth, and he that seeketh, findeth, and to him that knocketh, it shall be opened. Once you seek and you're knocking, God said, eventually I'm going to let you receive. But you have to have the right heart. You have to be in the right manner for God to bless you with it that you can receive. So, once again, we're going to end you. I'm going to end you back with that verse in Proverbs. Proverbs 27, verse 18. It says, whoso keepeth the fig tree shall eat the fruit thereof. So he that waiteth on his master shall be honored. While you're waiting on your master, you have to keep that fig tree. When you're gardening or you're keeping a tree, you have to water it. You have to plant it sometimes. You have to cut the dead branches off, prune it. But that's work. So you're not just waiting and not doing anything toward the goal while you're waiting. You're waiting and working and waiting on the master to do what he has to do to bless that work that you're putting in. Remember, everything that you do is a seed sown. A seed sown, everything, every word out of your mouth. Everything that you hear in your ear gate, everything that you you see with your eye gate, everything that you speak out of your mouth, which is another gate, it's a seed sown. And what does the Bible say? In Galatians chapter, I said that was the last verse, Galatians chapter 6, verse 7, it says, be not deceived, God is not mocked. Whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. So if you're sowing, and whatever you're sowing, you're going to reap the fruit of that thing that you're sowing. So you have to understand, you have to keep the fig tree, and the Bible says you're going to eat from that, from putting in that work. And he said, so he that waiteth on his master shall be honored. God wants to honor you. You put in the work, and you wait patiently on the Lord, but while you're waiting patiently, you're doing things toward that goal of receiving that promise. God shall honor you. So, ladies and gentlemen, I just wanted to give you all this. I love you all. I will see you all again soon. May God bless. Wait on the Lord. We are out.
Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? And they can't defeat me, that's the whole thing. Cause heaven's above me and God reigns. These truths I have to proclaim, make plain. So you could understand what it is I lay claim to. What I've gone through, uh-huh. To remind those who don't know how to find what's true, making sure we give honor to where